It's the day of the date. And while Tiger Island's Casanova Chris just washes and goes...
You're looking very chipper.
Actually washed your face and my hair. What can you tell?
Shark girl Niff spends a little bit longer getting ready.
My freckles are out, at least that looks vaguely cute.
Because Niff's going on a little trip, it feels like we're stuck at home, doesn't it? Like another boring night in front of the telly.
It's like that kind of surfer chick, like being too much.
It looks like you're not trying hard, but you've made an effort.
I don't know, I'm still going to take a lot of caution. I don't think they're genuine. I think it's all a big ploy to get something from our island, and I'm not sure what it is yet, but I'm going to work that out today. We'll find out. But I'm still going to take it with... Oh, still treat him like a snake. Oh.
Do me proud, mate. Do me proud. You have to look good when you swim. That's the main thing, all right? Look good.
It's time for both islands to send off their lovebirds.
Now I'm getting nervous. It's like your mum waving you off.
Don't be nervous. Just do it. Like John said, go have fun.
Okay, I'm going to have fun. Sharks, man.
Sharks. Yeah, remember when you're out there?
Yeah.
You're a shark.
Bye.
Come on, girl.
I reckon he's probably going to pull. Because he's not a bad looker, and I reckon she's up for out.
So what do you think of the concocted poem?
One of the lines okay. Is for a song, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, one of the lines I can't take full credit for.
Who wrote that? And why, how come nobody who had the diary or anything gave you a piece of paper to write it on? That's one.
We thought that was quite rustic.
Yeah, with the whole
the
kind
burnt
of burnt edges.
Yeah, we were quite happy with that. That's from our tube bars. Yeah, the peaches and shaker tree, that was... He said it and then I wrote it and he's like, I can't believe you just wrote that.
She will love it. I promise you. That's got the Crawf seal of approval written all over it.
Your judgment is pants. He's not getting anything from that note.
That will get she'll be like, ooh, don't know how to take it.
No, she'll be like, oh my god, I'm never leaving camp again.
See you later.
Yeah.
Good seeing you, and I'll see you on Sunday.
Yeah, definitely. I look forward to it.
See you later.
I don't think I've spoken to him enough yet to be able to say, oh yeah, I think I really fancy him or anything like that. I think he's a good looking chap and he seems like a nice enough guy, but I will keep you informed of. I'll let you know on Sunday what I think about the whole thing and how I feel about the whole situation.
No, I was chatting to him a lot. Did you talk about any romance? No, nothing.
I don't know, man.
You don't know?
No. Wasn't feeling it. She looked pretty hot though.
She looked alright.
Yeah, we pulled her out to sea and I was like, yeah. She looked fine, so that...
I'm sure she did.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to Sunday seeing her again.
Bet you are.
Early evening on Shark Island, and there's a storm brewing. Geoff has hidden the group's weekly ration of matches, and he's enjoying watching his fellow sharks search for them.
Please think, Geoff, OK? You know this when we did lunch, right? You know how I couldn't get the match to do it, so you did it, right? And it all went up. Where did you put the box? Because we can't find the box.
I've got a bad memory. You're really asking the wrong person this question right now.
Yeah, but you're the only person who knows where the matches are and we're not going to get a fire going. We can't light any of our lanterns. So you kind of need to remember this one, if possible.
I always get blamed for stuff. I'm a bit sick of getting blamed, you know. I think it's
John
pretty harsh.
John gave them to you to light the fire and they haven't been seen since. So it'd be a bit nice if you could help us try and find them.
Could be in the bin.
Why would they be in the bin, Geoff?
I don't know. Some of you haven't checked.
You can check that if you want. Do you think you put them in the bin?
Don't think I have, but they could be.
And now we have no matches to start a fire for dinner or start lanterns or anything. Which I think is hysterical. But I think I'm the only one who thinks that. And I think I'm going to get in so much trouble.
It's like an exciting game of hide and seek.
And what makes it slightly more interesting is the clouds look like they can make it even more interesting by bringing forth a storm, which I think would be absolutely brilliant. So there's five of us in the dark, in the middle of nowhere, with no light, cold food, in the middle of a thunderstorm.
Without matches, the sharks can't cook or light their lanterns. Geoff is still pretending he doesn't know where they are, and Niff is getting increasingly frustrated with him.
Why do you have to be such a prat about it, Geoff?
Why did you get so upset about it, Niff?
I'm not upset about it. What I'm upset about is the lack of help you seem to be able to give the rest of the group when it's something as vital as being able to see and also being able to warm some food up. It's not just you.
What do you expect me to do? I'm mad to get some matches.
No, you could at least come and have a look before the blooming sun went down.
I said to wash up.
You have absolutely no ability of prioritising anything in your head. It's the means of our dinner and our light for the evening.
Coming up, the claws are out on Tiger Island.
You didn't make her feel welcome.
I've been gutted. I wanted to go home.
Whatever.
And Shark Boy Geoff goes in for the kill.
You're such a patronising, artificial person.
On Shark Island, Geoff has hidden the group's only box of matches, and with no fire, there's no food. So the hungry sharks resort to a more primitive fire-making method.
Geoff, look for the matches. Actually, look.
I have.
You're just useless. What is your point in even being here?
I don't know.
Because Geoff is refusing to help look for the matches, the rest of the group are becoming infuriated with him.
There's not much more I can do.
You can look for the matches.
You want to calm down.
You want to get a grip on reality, mate.
So do you. It's a box of matches.
It's your fault.
No one's going to die because of it.
I think it's our words.
Meanwhile, the Tigers go all out to impress new arrival Alara on her last night with them and throw a salsa party.
We're just getting our steps going. So it's, you go backwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7.
Oh, no.
2, 3, 4.
And Dark Horse Crawford is the man with the moves as he reveals he takes salsa lessons back home in London.
Normally on Mondays I'm in the Hammersmith Community Centre doing my salsa, so I've got to represent and make sure I do my group proud.
Go on then, show us.
Katie, my dear, you ready? Come on.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 3.
Katie and Crawford's flirty dancing hasn't gone unnoticed by Badu.
I think Crawford does like Katie, definitely, because when there was salsa and there's a little bit of pant moveage, which was apparently obvious, and there wasn't any pant movement with Alara when he was salsaing with her.
Took out the guitar, man.
It's getting close to midnight, and miraculously, the sharks' matches have finally turned up.
Yes.
After hours of looking, Niff eventually found them in the bin, where Geoff had hidden them.
He hides the matches. It just shows how much of a lack of consideration for everyone he has. And then we go without, like, proper dinner. I cannot stand the boy. I cannot stand him to bits.
It's new arrival Alara's final morning with the Tigers.
I am just getting everything packed and ready for my transfer to Shark Island. I'm a bit gutted really because I'm kind of settled here. And I'm quite happy just to sort of chill out and relax here now and get in with them all. But at the same time, I'm kind of excited because I can't wait to meet the other group and have a bit of fun with them.
What's that you done?
Dun, dun, dun.